All right, what's happening, everybody? It's Jay Chase. Like, share, subscribe, dive, duck, dick, dive, dive, dive. Hey, I wanted to talk about line lock. For those of you that like to race, especially light to light, but for those of you who like to race, I want to talk about line lock. So, back in the day, when we used to race, there was something that you could buy that was called line lock. And what line lock would do is that, let's say that you were going to race somebody and you were on the line. You're on the line and you're waiting for the green light. So what you do is you hit the switch for your line lock, and what your line lock does is the line lock will apply your front brakes so that you can spin your back tires freely. When we were younger, we used to power brake it. And power brake is when you have the brake on and you punch the gas at the same time. And, you know, you spin your tires, but your car doesn't really move. But what you're actually doing is you're forcing the car to spin the back tires against the pressure that you're putting on the brake pedal. You know, so you're like chewing up your brakes. So you get this thing, it's called line lock. And what it does is it locks up the front calipers of your car, so your front brakes are basically locked up. And that frees up your back brakes. So if you want to punch your, you know, punch the accelerator, you want to spin your back tires to heat them up, you get better traction. Line lock is something that helps. So when you're racing, there's a couple of different things that you can do if you don't have line lock. If you have an automatic, rear wheel drive have a automatic, Jesus, why can't I talk? If you have a rear wheel drive car with an automatic transmission, there's a stall converter in there. The stall converter is basically a round adapter that basically attaches the engine to your transmission, and you can adjust the RPM range of your torque converter. For instance, most factory torque converters are 18 to 2200 RPMs. So what that means is if you put your foot on the brake and you give it gas at the same time, your engine will come up a certain amount of RPMs before your tires will break loose. Does that make sense? So if you have a rear wheel drive car, an automatic transmission, you adjust the stall converter. You take out the standard one that is put in from the factory, get rid of that because it's shit. And you want to put in a big one. Now, I had a small block 350, Chevy 350, and I had it attached to a turbo 350 transmission. And I had a 3,800 RPM stall on it. And what that would mean is that when I'm sitting at a light and I'm ready to, I'm ready for the green light, that means that I can bring my RPMs up all the way up to 3,800 RPMs before my tires will break loose. So let's say that I have line lock. So my brakes are on, I give it gas, and the RPMs will go all the way up to 3,800 RPMs before the tires break loose. So that's where I'm going to basically be leaving the line once the green light starts. I'll leave the line at 3,800 RPMs. You get the high performance race cars, heavy sponsored ones. I've seen 5,000 RPM stall converters, and that means you don't leave the line when the light turns green. Your RPMs are already up at 5,000 RPM. Now, if you can just imagine the benefit that that would be if you're racing somebody and they're just sitting at the light waiting to put their foot on the gas, your RPMs are already up to, you know, 3,800 RPMs. You get a good jump off the line. It's basically what line lock does and what stall converters do. I don't know why I made this video. I like talking about cars. I like talking about racing. And if you want to talk about racing, let's talk. I don't know why. I don't know why I made this video. Stall converters, line lock. There's so much more.